One of the more difficult things about this whole process was losing my independence and still fighting for it, but realizing that it's okay to accept help at some points. I had lived, prior to diagnosis, I had lived on my own for 11 years. I'd lived all the way down in the southern states. I, like, 23 hours from home. I was very independent. And then all of a sudden, for treatment, my mom moves in with me, and, you know, it went better than expected, having my mom looking after me all the time. But it was a little bit of a blow to the ego to know that after my surgery, I couldn't wash my own hair. So my mom had to help me wash my hair and everything like that. And then I was determined at the beginning of chemo that, you know, I'm just going to stay in Brandon. I just want to stay at home. I want to be in my own home and to do the chemo. And then I was doing that. And then 1 week, my brother came to stay with me on his spring break, and I was on chemo. And he went back and he told my mom she shouldn't be staying by herself. He totally ratted me out. And from then on, I ended up just accepting the help and going and staying with my family in Saskatchewan during my rounds of chemo. I tell myself it's more for their peace of mind, but it's actually been really helpful for me.